So hi, once again we are in Cognit Lab, and this is the 8th tutorial of how to learn Python from the basic to advanced. And in this video we are covering up what is module, what is pre-built libraries, how can you use it, how can you import it, what is mean by importing, all of this. So let's start. So now we are here. So now let's zoom out. So let's think that you have some code in a page, and in that code you have also a function of exponent. So now what is exponent mean? Exponent mean e. If you read 11th math book, then you probably know what is exponent mean. Exponent mean e to the power something that will give a value. So here we create a function that will take a value as a parameter, and that will giving a value by doing the exponent of that number. So now we have this function in a page. We have to use it in another page. So now let's think, here we have another page of coding, and in that page we have to use that function from that page. We don't have to rewrite the function or retype the function in that page also. We just have to use from that page. So how can you use it? So for that we have to make that page into a library. So here the library terms come. So we have to make that as a library or as a module. So many of pupils are make their pages or their function, their codes in a library or in a module. So now let's think someone made some codes of exponent and various mathematical calculation or operational function, and we have to use that, and the name of that library is NumPy. So now how can you use that? So for that, first you have to go into your search bar of your computer, and then you have to write cmd, and then a command prompt is come. You have to click on that. So now you have to give a command, and that command will be pip one space, then install, then the name of that library. Anything, any library or any module you have to install on your computer or on your IDE, PyCharm or Jupyter, anything, you have to first install that in your computer. For that you have to type this command on your command prompt, and that will be pip install, and then the name of that library you want to install. So now here we install NumPy. So what is NumPy? NumPy is a library, is a page of a code that can give us many function of many mathematical calculation. We can use it by from our page to that page. So how can you do that? Let's think. First we have to install that. So for that we have to use this command in command prompt, and that will be pip install and then NumPy, and then you have to click enter. And be remember, you need internet connection for that, and then it will be downloading. So I have already download that, so it's seeing that requirement already satisfied. So now you have to close that after downloading and installing. That will be download, and that will be installed in your computer. And then you have to go into the file section of your PyCharm ID or Jupyter ID, that based on your use, what are you using now. So now you have to go on file, click on file, then go to the setting, and then go to the your project file that is here. If in the, it is the name of that project file you can create here, you have to click here, and then you have to click project interpreter, and then here you see there have many libraries or modules. Then you have to click on this plus icon, and then you have to search here what you need. So now here we need NumPy library, so you have to search NumPy, and then you got the library, and then you have to click that, and then you have to click on install package. And after installing you need, so we remember that you need internet connection for that also, that it will showing package NumPy installed successfully. So I already have installed, so it's showing install. So it probably takes 2.5 minutes for that to install. Then you have to close that, and then you have to close also that. Now how can you use that library? You successfully install that library in your computer, in your IDE. So now how can you use that codes of another page into this page? This is your page, this is your coding page. So how can you use those function of that page in from this page? So for that we have a syntax, and that is called import. So first you have to write import, import, and after that you have to give a space, and then and then type the name of that library that you want. So here we're using NumPy, and then you have to type as, and then by what name you have to call that in your page. So here the original name is NumPy, but here we are calling that as np. So here whenever we use NumPy, we call as np. We are not calling here as NumPy, because here we are telling that import NumPy as np. That means this NumPy will be imported in this page as np name, not as NumPy name. So hope you understand this syntax. Imports mean importing some other codes of some other page into a page, that is called import. So here you importing NumPy, that is a code of a other page, into this page, and as a name of np. So here you can use np to call that page, and then you have to call that function. Now let's think, there have a function, you can see exponent in that NumPy page. So how can you use that? So first, here it's give a value. Whenever you give a value into this function, it return us a value, and that will be exponent of that value. Now here, how can you get that? So first we have to use that name that we can give here. So first we have to type that name, and then give a dot, and after that we have to type that function that we want to use from that page. So here we have to use exponent function of that page. So first we have to type the name of that library as the name we are using here. So and then we have to give a dot, and then the name of that function, and then it's take a value, and it's written a value. So we give a value, and then we can save the value into k. Then we have to print the k. So now let's see what happened when we click on run. So here it's taking 7 and it's giving 1096. So now we can get a value. So now you can learn how can you use a function of a other page code into a page, and that is this syntax. You have to write this import, and then the library name, and then the name that you have to use in this page, and then you have to type that name that you're using in this page, by what name you are using in this page, and then a dot, and then the function that you want to use, and then if the function is taking any parameter you can give, on if not take then you don't have to give, and if it's giving a value return then we have to save that. So whatever we need based on our function. So first of all, whenever you have to use a library or module, you have to install that first on your computer by command prompt, by that command pip install, and then whatever the library or whatever the module you have to use, the name of that module or library, and then you have to click enter. Then you must have internet connection, and that will be downloaded successfully and installed. Then you have to come into PyCharm or any ID, and then you have to go file, then the project, then the interpreter, and then you have to click on plus icon, and then you have to install that by searching. So hope you understand how can you use a library. Library means nothing but a extra page of a code where many function will be written, and we have to use that function, all that function in from a other page, and that is called a library, and that we have to import that in another page. So hope you understand. So now let's talk about more what is NumPy library, how many features it have. So NumPy is a mathematical library that will give us many mathematical function that we can do, many mathematical operation, logical operation, many things. So first you can see that NumPy has an exponent function that will give a exponent of any value. So now what more it have? So let's see what more it have. So now we have another concept of array. So what is array? So list of a list is called array. So let's take example, and now let's k equals to 1, 2. So this is called an array, and this array will be one dimensional array. Why? Because we have only one list in a list. So first big brackets is for a list, and in that list we have also a list, and that will be this list, and the list element will be 1 and 2. There have only 2 elements. So this list of a list is called an array. So this is called a 1D array. So how can you write a 2D array? By just giving second list, and now there have 2 lists in a list. So it's a big list, and in that big list we have 2 under list, and this is called a 2D array because in that list we have 2 lists. So this is called an array, and this call will be 2D or 2 dimensional array. So if we can write more, that will be 3 dimensional, 4 dimensional. So this is called an array. So hope you understand what is array. So now by using NumPy we can create array. So in NumPy we have a features called randomize array or random.random that is create an array with random values. So now So let's think we need a array, multi-dimensional array. That means in a list we have many lists. We have to create that by random number. We don't give any numbers. We need by random numbers. For that we have a function in NumPy, that is numpy.random.random. random.random, and then you have to give two four parentheses, okay, two four parentheses, and then in middle of those you have to give how many columns you need and how many rows you need. So now what is rows and what is columns? So now the horizontal line is called row and the vertical line is called a column. So now what is that? So let's take an example that we have 1 2 3 4, sorry, 4, and then we have 3 2 1 4, then so this is a two-dimensional array. We have two lists in a list, so this is called a two-dimensional array. So in this array the number of rows is 1 2 3 4. Because of in that horizontal line how many element you have, based on that many rows you have. So here we have 4 rows because in every new list we have only 4 element, and for that the rows will be 4. Now how many columns we have? The vertical line will be told you how many columns you have in a list. So here in vertical line we have only 2 lists. So how many lists in a list you have, that is called a column. So now here we have 1 2 column, and we have 4 row in each column. So this is the first column or first list, and in first column we have 4 row, mean 4 elements. So that is column and row. So now hope you understand. So now let's give, so we don't know, is it taking first column or list as a parameter. So let's try by ourselves. So let's give 2 and 3 and let's print it. So now click on run. We are getting 1, 2, 3, 3 row and 2 column. So the first parameter will be column, because we have get 2 column by giving 2. So first parameter will be column and second parameter will be row. So here we got 1, 2, 3, and these all numbers are randomized value. By doing binomial distribution or sample distribution, is type of a distribution that is create some random number. So this is create a random numbers and in an array and in a shape of multidimensional array, and the shape will be 2 column and 3 row. So let's change it into 4 column and 3 row. Let's see what happened. When click on run, we get 1 2 3 4 list, that means 4 column, and 1 2 3 element per column, that means 3 row. So hope you understand, this vertical line is called column and this horizontal line is called row. So hope you understand what is the concept behind row and column. So here we have one more function. Let's think that we don't have to create an array, we just want to create a random number into a variable. So how can you create? By just giving. So let's think that we need an integer, random integer. So we have to create that by NumPy library. So let's take np dot, and then what we want to do, then we have to give random again. So random, and then dot rand int. So now this is the function to create any random integer for a variable. So first you have to name, then dot, then random, then dot rand int mean integer, and between of this parentheses we have to give a parameter, and that parameter will be the range. So you have need an integer, but you have a max value that you don't want to cross. So let's think you need integer that's below from 7, then you have to give 7. All the random numbers are created by this function is below from 7, so this is called a range. So you have to give that parameter, that what is the max of this random number, and that will be 7. So every time it's create a new number for that. Let's click on run, it's giving 3. Let's see more, it's giving 2. So you can see, but it do not give any 7 because that will be max. it was giving the lower number that in between of this parenthesis. So now hope you understand this function also. So there are also many tons of methods or many tons of function. So you have to try by yourself. In previous tutorial, two video, the most important tutorial, we can learn two technique to how to create new syntax, how to know the syntax of new function, how can you know parameter without knowing anything, without having any pre-knowledge. If you does not watch that video in up, you can see this flash, you can click on that and you can watch that, because that is the most important part for the whole series. So you have to watch that, because the two techniques of creating new syntax is most important. So now here, how can you do that? By just giving the library name and then dot, and then first you have to just typing a letter, and this block of this window will be appear, and here you have all this function that will be available in this library. So now you can see, you can use one by one by our previous technique. So you have to know our two techniques that will be discussed in tutorial 2. So now there are many features. So that's it. I do not tell you more about this, because there are many function you can use based on it. There have derivatives, you can do many mathematical calculation, so there have many types of things. So there are lots of other libraries also, like pandas, scikit-learn, they have offer machine learning, and they have also many others libraries. Based on your work, you can use that. So that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, please do subscribe, like and share. And in next video, we can learn what is class, and the class will be the last part of our video, and then the Python basic will be end, because the last part of this series will be the class, object oriented programming. So we have to understand what is class and how can you create all the programs in a class. So in previous video, we talk about class and function. That function is a package, and we can see how can you create function. And I already told in that video that class is same thing as a function, like a package, but that is class is called like a design. We have to create object by that design. So we are discussing it in the next video. So thanks for watching. Bye bye. We are seeing in the next video.